We'll find out tomorrow night. This morning now on The Breakfast Show, we are joined by one of the defining dance pop groups of the 90s. They came back into our lives, thank goodness, last year with their brilliant new album, What the Future Holds. They are back today to tell us all about their new tour, when we can all join them and sing and dance again. Good morning to the girls, Claire and Faye from Stubbs.
Morning.
Good morning, Zoe.
Oh, hello, ladies. Richie, we've had to tie Richie to his chair. He's so overexcited in the travel booth downstairs. How's life been treating you since we last spoke?
Oh, well, much the same, I suppose. I think it's all still been very weird for all of us, isn't it? We are kind of, I've never spent so much time in my house.
I know, discovering areas I've never seen before.
I've never spent so much time and achieved so little.
I know, because that's it. The first lockdown, we're all like, oh, I'm going to build this and we're going to do this and I'm going to tidy out the cupboards. And now we're all like slobs lying around in our leisure wear and praying for a change. Well, it's so great to have you guys on the show. How has the reception of the new album been? Your fans have gone crackers for it, haven't they?
Oh my goodness, we are so overwhelmed by what a lovely response we've had to the whole of the album. We're on our third single already, and it's gone down a storm. All the dancing on TikTok and everyone joining with choreography as well and the videos. Yeah, we're absolutely blown away.
That's been a special thing. You've got your fans. Are they called Steppers, by the way?
I think they kind of are. I don't know if there's an official name, is there?
Yeah, apparently Steppers, I think that's what Richie said. Oh, what was his was Steptaculars, I think was another suggestion from Richie, only Richie, of course. But I love this idea that you've asked the fans to choreograph their own routines. Have you been impressed with the quality?
There has been some incredible videos sent on social media to us with some brilliant ideas. Some people have mashed up some of our old choreography. Some are like doing some really sassy, interesting things. It's been brilliant fun to see what they've come up with. Yeah.
Excellent stuff. I love it. I'm sure Richie has sent in his suggestions as well. Also, loving the new single, To the Beat of My Heart. Molly King helped to write this song.
Yeah, there's quite a few writers credited on this. M&EK is one of them as well, which is quite exciting.
I know.
it's just something that came across our manager's desk. Actually, no, that's not even true.
Hang on, you're just making this up now.
They used to look after Molly as well. I think she must have written and recorded the demo for herself and for some reason didn't record it. So we got it instead, thankfully, which is a very nice addition to the album.
Yeah, I know, it's brilliant. I love that. It's quite amazing when you hear how a song is put together, that it starts here with one person and then someone else puts a bit more magic in it. And have to say, have you seen Drag Race UK last night? M&EK, marvellous.
Not yet. I haven't seen it. I'm catching up with it today.
Yeah, I'm not telling you anything because it is possibly one of the best episodes I've ever seen. You have recorded some tracks for us at home. We are delighted. The fans, the Steppers, the Steptaculars, whatever they want to call themselves, are waiting. So here it is, recorded at home, To the Beat of My Heart. It's Steps. More chat with Claire and Faye after this.
Tell me, do you think of me? Wonder what
She loved it. The fans loved it. Darren, I like that Steps track a lot. Hashtag old geezer. See, your fans are all ages. Claire and Faye are on the line. Morning to Eight and Lisa and Lee if they're listening at home as well. Oh, we absolutely love it. We're all doing our own little dance routines. I'm doing mine in my office chair. Emma from Weymouth Girls says, can you tell us more about the sound check tickets for your tour? Tour happening later on in the year, fingers crossed, starting in November, November the 2nd, up in Sheffield.
I know. Well, I think the sound check tickets mean that you get to sit in the empty arena while we do our sound check, which we have never, ever done before. It's something that we always keep that really private normally. But yeah, you get to come in and you sit and you listen to us to do our sound check and make sure everything's okay when there's no one else in the arena. And then I think you also get a meet and greet with us afterwards with everybody else.
It's amazing. I love it because you get the warts and all there, don't you? You get to see everyone who's in a good mood, who's had a falling out, who's forgotten the steps.
Oh, yeah. It means I'm going to have to put makeup on for the sound check now, which I didn't think.
We don't mind.
We don't mind at all. We like you. You're beautiful. I haven't worn makeup for about 9 months now, I think it is.
No,
I know. Everyone in here keeps complaining that look at the state of our film. Let herself go. Also, I love some of the fascinating things we've been learning about you this year. John Courtney, was it John Courtney on Britain's Got Talent? Only turns out that Faye was his glamorous magician's assistant back in the day. Did you ever do the Saw the Lady in Half trick?
Oh my goodness, I've done it all, Zoe. It was really funny because literally John was the first person that I ever did magician's assisting for. And because of him, I've ended up doing it loads of times in really random shows and places. And of course, more recently on the Royal Variety with Stephen Mulhern.
Oh, yes.
But yeah, I've in and out of boxes, my head chopped off, my legs chopped off, the lot. I mean, you name it, I've done it.
She has done it. Do you know, it's my dream. It's my dream. I don't know if they'd get me in the box anymore. Claire, also, you are the new Mary Berry. You've been doing a little bit of baking at home in lockdown. Your social media feed makes my mouth water. What's your speciality, Claire?
Oh, do you know what?
Tiger green curry is a good...
So I've made that quite a lot. But baking wise, I've kind of got into bread a little bit, making my own bread, which I've never tried before. And it's really quite easy.
It's so nice. Yeah, tell that to Curly Sue at home. Yeah. It's still not mastered that sourdough. No, it's beautiful. It's beautiful, that sourdough.
Oh, no, I've not tried sourdough. I thought about it and then saw the effort that goes into it and then changed my mind. Yeah, we're not trying that hard.
Oh, okay. I mean, it looks quite impressive, I have to say. We need to get you on Celebrity Bake Off. Now, okay, we're going to hand over to your super fan, the Steptacular, Richie Anderson, to ask Steps anything. Richie, you can take over now.
Okay, so I asked my fellow Steps fans to ask you anything. And we'll start with you then, Faye. Jean Samuel in Banbury says, in lockdown, what has been your specialist homeschool subject?
PE. I struggled with maths. I think Benjamin's better at maths. I quite enjoyed doing French because he's got lots of oral French that he has to do, so he has to say the words out loud. So I'd say French and PE, or maybe art.
Très bien. Kyle on Twitter says, Claire, was there anything in the Steps pipeline that never materialised?
I don't actually think I can't remember anything. There's stuff that we're working on at the moment. There's one particular thing that I'm really trying to get rid of because I don't like it. But I'm not going to say, just in case.
You have to tell me afterwards. What's that?
Kevin in Northampton says, Faye, if they did an I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here step special, who would cope the best and the worst in the jungle, please?
So I think Lee would be the best, and I think Claire would be the worst, actually. I do. Food situation, home comforts, and bugs. That's
Paul Goldman says, Claire, if you had to recruit a pop star to be your sixth member, who would it be, please?
Well, I'm going to have to say this because if I don't, he'll kill me. And he always says that he's first on the list. He's not technically a pop star, but Rylan. He thinks he's a sixth member anyway.
Yeah.
That is amazing. He would. Oh, can you imagine? I know he's a good, close, personal friend. Morning to the boy who's listening today. Jess wanted to know, would you ever consider Eurovision? Good question.
We've got quite a split camp on this one, haven't we? We've got some people would say yes and some people would say no, thank you. But we all enjoy it as a show, but to actually do it is a split camp.
Okay. Oh, Richie, I'm going to leave you two to talk to the girls to find out the answer to that and who's on whose camp. Richie, lovely work from Richie
Anderson.
Thank
you to the Steps fans.
Listening to Steps on Zobel with my boyfriend Gary, says Joe, we love Steps, forever steppers they are. Gary and Joe, be well chuffed that we're now going to play a piece that you've recorded at home. It's Stomp, your second and final number one single, released in 2000. Girls, give them a love to the whole gang, won't you? Thanks for coming on the show.
Thank you for having us. And, Hope to see you all in November.
Yes, fingers crossed. Fingers crossed that'll happen. Get your vaccines, people. We need to go to the Steps tour.
Thank God for the weekend. Now is the time for feeling all right. Come and taste the spice of life. Let it into you. You know what you gotta do. Every Friday when my work is done, I get my party on. I call a few friends of mine, make sure I'm looking fine. I know we're gonna have a real good time. Yeah. Everybody clap your hands, get on up.
Stomp still sounds incredible. We need to hear it on tour, please, says Kev. Everybody, good morning. Just dance around the kitchen with my beautiful daughter, Orla. Loving Steps. She's 4 today, the same as her uncle Ben, who's 46. Happy birthday to both of them. Steps are incredible. So glad they're back. Becky in Stroud. And Claire and Faye and the gang will hopefully be off on tour later on this year. Tour kicking off in November. All the arenas, everybody, if you get to go, it's going to be phenomenal. And the new album, What the Future Holds, is out now. We love Steps. Happy boy, Richie Anderson.
Oh, did I hold it together all right?
You were very cool. You were sort of disappointingly cool, actually. No, that was brilliant. Thank you so much for gathering all those questions from the fans. Give us